Beautiful Leo. Hi, beautiful Leo. Do you know that I have some very special people in my world that are Leos? I certainly do. It is lovely to have you here. For those of you who are new, I am Jackie B. I am a light worker, an intuitive, and a manifesting mentor. There are so many channels on YouTube that you could choose from, and you are here, and I am grateful for that. To those of you who are returning, again, I cannot tell you how grateful I am. If this reading resonates, please like, comment, subscribe, join the family. Also, check out your sun, moon, rising. It'll give you a full picture of the lowdown of what's going on in your energy field. Let's get started. General for Leo, please. I'm just pulling out messages, babes. Just pulling out messages. This is timeless, so you'll see it when you're meant to. Thank you, Spirit, Angels, Guides, and Spirits. Guide me for Leo, please. Thank you. That was an interesting shuffle. My shuffles are so interesting today. All right. To the sea. Time to go. Community. So what I'm getting from this is that you are in a situation at the moment where you're not entirely sure where this is taking you, but you feel very called to go this way, and it's to do with community, it's to do with service, so it's to do with finding your people, your tribe, right? And so you're on an adventure and you're not entirely sure where you're going to land or what it's going to look like, but you know it's time to go. You know that you've got to move on this because it's part of your evolution. It's part of your potential here on this physical plane. Did I even show you those cards? Maybe very briefly. It's all right, the message is here. Can I get some clarity on what this situation is, please, Spirit? Going on for Leo, please, Spirit. Nine of Cups. Excuse me. Feeling fulfilled. There is definitely like a wish fulfillment. Something that really matters to you and means something to you. It happened. It could be about love, or it could be about something that really means something to you. It could be the community, you know, serving. And you're trying to make that happen. And it's clarified by, if this, you know, this is crazy. The Hierophant and the Strength card. What that's talking about. Because it's clarifying the Nine of Cups, which again is wish fulfillment, getting what you want, a particular thing coming to fruition. The Hierophant could be contracts, long-term commitments, even marriage. It can do with religion or beliefs or someone's values. And then we're looking at the Strength card. So, which is perseverance, but it's also like the unknown and not knowing where it's going to go and going anyway. So this is the fulfillment was some kind of commitment, some kind of contract, and you're not entirely sure where it's going, but it matters to you, and so you're going to give it a shot anyway for the sake of the community, or maybe you and your family, or you and your family and your extended family, or you being in alignment with self in order for you to reach your potential to serve or be a healer or look after other people, do good in the world, you know, be a hub for people who need you in whatever aspect that might be. What is this about, Spirit? Wow. Holy Toledo, Batman. Full card on an adventure. you are just cracking on. You're all in. You are just doing it, right? You're just doing it. Uninhibited adventure. Just all in. All in. Clarified by judgment. And justice. Isn't that insane? Totally meant to be. You're meant to be on this adventure. This is karmic and like totally karmic, and it's balancing everything out. All that you've done, you are being rewarded. All that you've done, all that you've been through, all that you've worked on, it's all coming to fruition. You are getting what you deserve, what you worked hard for. Everything is coming back into balance. It's this uninhibited adventure. The strength card, being persistent. There is something that's been offered to you, or some kind of commitment to something that you really wanted, and you are just all up in it. Like, you are all for it. This is what you worked hard for. This is what you wanted. This is what you prayed for or set intentions for. By keeping it very general, they're not giving me any clues as to what it is. Yeah, I agree. Spirit just said that, it's because there are quite a lot of you that are in this energy, but it's about different things. Advice. Wow. The Star card. I mean, people adore you. People, you're the star. You're meant to be seen. You're meant to be seen. You're meant to be out there. You're meant to be valued. You're meant to be a boss, or you're meant to be a rock star, or you're meant to be on TV, or you're meant to be, you're meant to have a YouTube channel. You're, like, you've got, and you, because of your flow, because of your creativity, because of your bright shining light, and because of your ability to bring light to others, you are meant to be seen. Clarified by the Knight of Pentacles, and everything is fine. The Ten of Swords. So what that's talking about is it's coming. Your wish, it's coming. I know it's been taking a while and it pisses you off. Or it took a while, but everything is fine. If you're waiting for something to come to fruition, it is coming. You're meant for that. But things haven't come fast for you. You've had to really, you've been through a lot to get to that. Okay? So last messages, please, Spirit. Would love some advice. Or outcomes. Outcomes would be cool. Please, Spirit. Okay, so we're talking now about advice, or just anyway. Seven of Swords. All right, so this is past betrayal. Being robbed, being somebody being careless with you, doing a number on you. It's clarified by the Four of Swords. This is resting and healing. Look at that. The Lovers. Not everyone's an asshole, babes. Not everyone's an asshole, male or female. I read for my boys as much as my girls. So I just want you to know that you're healing regarding love as well. You're really healing. You're taking time out to heal, which is beautiful. Okay. Outcome. Outcome, please, Spirit. Thank you so much. We love you, Spirit. All right. First card, Eight of Swords. Second card, Seven of Cups. Third card, Queen of Cups. First card, Eight of Swords. That card is talking about all of the worries that you have that go on are worries that have been created within. They're actually not real or reality. And what I mean by that is that it's all about perspective, Leo. You can either allow yourself to hold you back from making plans or doing things or engaging in something, or you can't, because you're trying to figure out what's best to do. You've got some options there and you're trying to figure out what is best, what's the best option. And Spirit is saying, go with your heart. What does your heart tell you? Queen of Cups. I mean, it's so perfect for this. For the community card. It's so perfect. Queen of Cups, of course. You're either a healer or someone who brings light. You're a nurturer. You love people. You just want to heal people. And you just want to be there for people and offer support. And you heal through healing others. And it's just a natural part of you that wants to do that. You're also a very deep feeling person. You're very connected to your emotions, male or female. You're very connected to your emotions, and it's important for you to be in flow. So when we say it's important for you to be in flow, being in flow for you puts you in alignment with what it is that you want. When you're in the Eight of Swords energy, you're not in flow. When you're freaking out about what some options, when you're freaking out about what to do, you're not in flow. So was it you that, I don't think it was you that had the Observer card pop out, but the Observer card's in my brain, that is for damn sure. What's in your heart, Spirit just said. You need to identify with what's in your heart. Flexible is talking about doing things differently. There is a change that is required in order for you to have what you want, and maybe that change is a shift in perspective once and for all. But you are just a phenomenal energy, so loving, so nurturing, so present, so connected. Such a deep spiritual healing energy coming from you. And so not everyone's an asshole, but you must be surrounded by people who value you and who lift you up, because you're the bomb, baby. You're the bomb. Love you, Leo. Please like, comment, subscribe. If you haven't already, check out the description box. So many ways that I can empower you, liberate you, empower you, lift you up, show you light, help you navigate things. It's all in the description box. And also check out your sun, moon, rising. It's really important so that you can get a full picture of what's happening for you. But thank you for being here. Love and light and all of the blessings I can muster. Bye for now.